questions that we still have, but at least there's a sense of relief now, at least it should be, for all the residents of Maine, quite frankly. All of us that watch this, because I mean, you can kind of feel the tension yourself, even though you're not there, you have something like this. So it's just one more tragedy, and the second part of the tragedy would be our Congress and other elected officials would do absolutely nothing, once again, as a result of this. So that's just an unfortunate side of the story.
And I think the families deserve some answers, especially if some of the things that you raised, right? The question of, you know, these red flags and
no question. I think Mossad are probably after them also, and wherever they may be in the world. But this is a 30,000 person fighting force of terrorists. They're underground. So the IDF, using both air and ground assets, 155 artillery principally, is trying to knock out not just the high-level leadership, but the actual commanders of fighting units. They got a lot of intel overhead. Remotely piloted vehicles, air assets. I'm sure the U.S. is also giving them intelligence on what's going on from our extensive satellite system. They're trying to set the Hamas up for lower resistance.